In the last class we discussed one of the important decision procedure methods, that is the natural deduction method. Earlier we also discussed truth table method and the semantic tableaux method. So in this lecture we will be talking about another different kind of decision procedure method, which is called as reducing a given propositional logical formula into its conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms. So either you can reduce the formula into disjunctions of conjunctions, that is DNF, or conjunctions of disjunction CNF. So what we will achieve with this particular kind of reduction of the formulas into disjunction and conjunction of normal forms, it is simple that so whenever you come across a conjunctive normal formula, suppose X and something else, P or not P, etc. and all, we will be talking about two different kinds of formulas and all. So we will be reducing the given propositional logical formulas into either conjunctions of disjunction or disjunctions of conjunctions and all. So in the conjunctive normal form it is like C1, C2, C3, etc. and all, whereas each conjunct is nothing but a disjunction and all, D1, D2, etc. and all, D3, D4, etc. So whereas in the case of DNF what we have is it is disjunctions of conjunctions and all. So we have conjunctions of disjunctions and disjunctions of conjunctions and all. So we will go into the details of it in a while from now. So now observe this first kind of formula. So in this formula the basic idea of reducing the formulas into conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms is this. So we know that in the case of conjunctive normal forms, suppose in the case of this thing, if a conjunction C1 and C2, C3, etc. So this is going to be true only when each conjunct is true and all, otherwise it is going to be false. So that is the semantics of P and Q. So this reduction of well-formed formulas into conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms also follows this particular kind of idea. So that is TTF and F, TF, TF, and then this formula is going to be false only in this case. In all other cases it becomes T. So that means if you have conjunctions of disjunctions and all, then if you come across in each conjunction you come across a literal and its negation and all, then obviously the formula is going to be true. So this formula is going to be true, this is true, this is true, every formula is going to be true, provided when you have a formula and its negation is already there. So in the same way in the case of disjunctions, in the case of DNF in particular, whenever you have a formula, a literal and its negation is there, then it makes the whole formula false, that means it makes the whole formula unsatisfiable. So this is the main idea that we will be using it. So what essentially we will be doing in reducing the given well-formed formula into conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms and talking about the satisfiability and of course validity, what we will be essentially doing is so we will try to reduce the given formulas which occur in this particular kind of format. So all the implications etc. For example if you have a formula P implies Q implies R, so what you will do is you will remove this implication by using the definition. So that is A implies B is nothing but not A or B. Either the reduced formula will have only disjunctions and negations, or the reduced formula from the given propositional logical formula which originally includes implication etc. and all, so that we will reduce it to only conjunction and its negations and all. So that is what we will be doing it in CNF and DNF, and in the process we will be able to talk about whether or not the formula is satisfiable etc. So the basic idea of reducing the given formula into conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms is this. Suppose if X is any well formed formula in the propositional logic which is of this particular kind of format XR PR not P. We know that PR not P is obviously a tautology, and anything which is a disjunction of tautology have to be true only. So because PR not P is already true, irrespective of whether X is true or X is false, that is going to be true only. So that means the given formula is obviously valid in all. Under whatever interpretation that you give it for X, either it is T or F, the variables that exist in X, so where even though it X becomes true or X becomes false, since PR not P is already true, so that it makes the whole formula true. So now the other idea is that disjunction is also considered to be associative, because purely disjunctive well-formed formulas is valid if it contains a variable and its negation and its unnegated form and all, like P or not P is there, and that is obviously tautology and all, that makes the other formula also true. So for example in this case not P or Q, it should be and in particular, it should not be R, not P or Q and P or not R. So this is considered to be valid because negation and unnegated forms are there here, so that makes the whole formula true, the first formula true and the second formula also is true, so that makes the whole formula true. So this is nothing but P implies Q, so this is considered to be valid since it can be grouped to give simply Q or not R. If you simplify this formula you will get Q or not R. So the existence of propositional variable both negated and unnegated is a sufficient condition for validity, so it is also considered to be necessary condition for validity and all. So what do we mean by validity? Any formula which is considered to be true, a tautology, is considered to be a valid formula and all. So now observe this particular kind of thing and all. For example, if you have a formula like this one X1 or X2 or not X2 and another formula X3 or X4 or not X4 and X5 or X6 or not X6, something like that. So now observe this particular kind of thing is a conjunction of all these formulas and all, so it is conjunctions of disjunctions and all, so that is why it is C and F. So now each conjunct consists of set of disjunctions and all. So now in this case this is already true, X2 or X, not X2 is true, so now irrespective of whatever is there here, this makes the whole formula true. So now in the same way a literal and its negation is already existing here, so that makes this thing true, so that makes the whole disjunct true, that means this is true, this is true, and even this is also, it is also the case that X6 and not X6 is also true, so all the conjuncts are true, so that is the case here. So all the conjuncts are true, that is why the resultant conjunct is also true, C1 and C2 and C3 is going to be true, that means a given formula is a tautology. So once you can show that it is a tautology, then you obviously can that is as good as saying that a given formula is a valid formula. So that is the reason why we reduce a given well formed formula which is in the complex form which includes implication, double implication, etc., into the normal forms which includes only conjunction and negation as its literals, or disjunction or negation as the only things which you see in those normal forms. So now existence of a propositional variable both negated and unnegated is a necessary and sufficient condition for inconsistency of pure conjunctive normal forms. For example, if you come across P and not P in the disjunctions in particular, so this formula is going to be like this. So in the case of these formulas, for example if you come across in the disjunct in particular, you come across a literal and its negation and all, so that makes the whole conditional false in a sense that P and not P is false, so each disjunct will become false, and disjunction is going to be false only when both disjuncts are false. In all other cases it becomes T. So in that way we will be able to know that when a given formula is also unsatisfiable and all, so provided a literal and its negation exist in that formula and all. So a conjunct is true when its all its conjuncts are true, that is what is the case which is explained on the board on the left hand side, whereas a disjunction is false when both the disjuncts are false. So now what is a CNF? So CNF stands for conjunctive normal forms, that means a given well formed formula you reduce it to conjunctions of disjunctions. So now it is D1 and D2 and D3, where D1 D2 are disjunctions and all. So disjunctions are represented by R and conjunctions are represented by N. So if it is conjunct of A B, then it is represented as A and B. Disjunct means A R B. So now a well formed formula in a propositional logic D1 and D2 and D3 and DN is said to be in conjunctive normal forms, especially when X is considered to be an unnegated conjunction. That means if it is unnegated conjunction means it is P and Q etc. and all. If it is a negated conjunction it will lead to disjunction and all. So that is why you have to rule out this possibility that X has to be an unnegated conjunction, and every conjunct in the disjunction D1, D2, D3 etc. and all in X is an unnegated disjunction and all. And the third condition is that every disjunct is considered to be a propositional variable. It has to be either a propositional variable or it might occur in the form of negation of a propositional variable, it should be in the form of P or it should be in the form of not P and all. So in short X is a conjunctive normal form if and only if it is a conjunctions of disjunctions, and no negation sign has an argument other than the singular propositional variable. So the idea here is this particular kind of thing. First we are trying to talk about conjunctive normal forms. So what is the conjunctive normal form? It is the conjunctions of disjunctions D2, D3 etc. Dn. So D1 and D2, D3, Dn etc. are considered to be conjunctions of disjunctions. So now the idea here is that this conjunctive normal form should have these things, that formula X is an unnegated kind of conjunction. For example if you have something like not D2 or something like that, for example let us say D1 is P1 P2 and let us say P3 or P4 etc. and all. Let us assume that these are the only two formulas that are there. So in the pure sense this is not considered to be a CNF, conjunctions of disjunctions and all, because it consists of negation of some kind of formula and all, negation of disjunction and all. So that means this formula has to be reduced, it will be reduced to not P3 and not P4 and all. So if it consists of negation of some kind of variables, then that is not considered to be a conjunctive normal form. So you have to ensure that all these three conditions are satisfied and all. X is an unnegated conjunction and all, and every conjunct in X is an unnegated disjunction, that is the thing which needs to be followed, and every disjunct in a propositional variable or the negation of it should have it is either a propositional variable or it should be the negation of that particular kind of variable. So let us consider some examples and all. Before that, a well formed formula is considered to be a degenerate conjunction. It appears like we have used these three rules and all, like X is an unnegated conjunction, so that is satisfied in this particular kind of formula P or not P and or Q. Actually this is a disjunction, but it looks like it is also, it can also be considered as a conjunction also, I mean conjunct C1. So X is an unnegated conjunction, there is no negation of a formula which is not of X and Y etc and all, which occurs there in this formula PR0 PRQ, and every conjunct in X is an unnegated disjunction. Here we don't have any negation of disjunction kind of thing occurs here, that means not of PRP etc will not figure out here. Second rule is also followed, and every disjunct is a prepositional variable or the negation of a prepositional variable, either P is the case, in the first one you have P and in the second case you have not P. So literal and its negation is there in all this. So every disjunct is a prepositional variable or the negation of a prepositional variable, and it satisfies this particular kind of conjunct which is written in the form of a disjunct, satisfies all the things in all. It is in that sense this is called as degenerated kind of conjunction. So usually it is a disjunct and all, but the whole term PR0 PRQ can still be treated as, if there is only one such kind of formula which exists there here, it can be called as a degenerate case of a conjunction. So why? Because we can still we can write like this. Of course this is P, this is a conjunct PR0 PRQ, maybe if you want to extend it you can write it as P and P or not P and not P, which doesn't make any sense and all, but still you can write it in that way, Q and Q etc, Q and Q is same as Q etc, or you can even write it as PR in various ways you can write it and all, but this is an example of degenerate case. So what essentially we are trying to talk about is this particular kind of thing, CNF. So what is a CNF? First of all, it is a conjunction of disjunctions and all. This is conjunctions of disjunctions and all. So D1, D2, D3, etc. So now each one is called as the degenerated case of this one is PR, not P or Q, because it follows all the three rules of the one which we have talked about. So now some kind of convention which we follow for coming up with CNF and DNF of a given well-formed formula. So the conventions are like this: no redundant disjuncts occur in any conjunct in a CNF conjunctive normal form. So that means if you come across a formula such as PR PR PRP, something like that, it is simply represented as P only, however number of times it occurs and all in the formula, 3 times 4 times it doesn't matter, but it is treated as P only because you are not saying anything more than P only here. So redundant disjuncts will vanish and all, so now we will just write it as PRP. So it is like in the Boolean logic we have 1 R1, that is 1 plus 1 is 1 only, so the same thing which is followed here also. So the only thing which we are talking about here is that instead of disjunction we are instead of plus operation we are talking about disjunction. So that is the first thing, the convention which we follow, and the second thing is no redundant conjuncts occur in the conjunctive normal forms, just like P and not Q, and suppose if you have another P and not Q it is reduced to P and not Q, even if it occurs 100 times and all, but it is still treated as P and not Q. The third thing is that within disjunctions, that is D1, D2, D3 etc and all, variables appear in the alphabetical order. If it doesn't appear in the alphabetical order, you need to use distribution laws or associative law and make it in some particular kind of order. So now particular order with the unnegated occurrence of a variable preceding the negated occurrence of a variable. It's like so that means unnegated ones should come first whereas the negated ones come later. So now for example observe this particular kind of thing, not PR R, not Q or Q or P etc and all. So here negated form came first and then unnegated form came later, etc. and all. We need to reorder this particular kind of thing. Suppose if you follow this particular kind of convention, like A, B, C, etc., and some order we will follow. So now this will change to, so the first disjunct, that is not P R R or not Q or Q or P, changes to P R Q or not Q or not Q or R. So we are reshuffling this particular kind of thing, and then we are putting it in some kind of order. After P, Q follows, Q, R follows. Now this is only for our convenience, you know. So these are the three thing conventions which we follow, so that you know we will avoid lot of redundancy, etc. So now how to convert a given well-formed formula into its corresponding conjunctive normal form. In the same way, you can apply the same procedure to reduce the given well-formed formula into disjunctive normal forms, where a disjunctive normal form is disjunctions of conjunctions. So first what you need to do is we need to use some definitions to remove the occurrences of implication, double implication and R, so that you know it will be converted into conjunctions, you know. So then you use De Morgan's laws and the law of double negation, that is not not P is equivalent to P, to remove all the negations which are there outside the brackets and all. For example, if you have not of X and Y, it will become not X or not Y. In the same way, not of X or Y will become not X and not Y. So now then you have to use the double negation to ensure that no variables preceded by more than one negation sign, that we need to ensure. And then of course we need to follow some other kinds of rules, such as distributive law, PRQ or R, nothing but PRQ and PRQ R PRR. Actually this should be PR Q and R, or you can use P and Q or R. If it is PR Q and R, it will become PRQ and PRR. If it is P and Q or R, it will become P and Q or PR P and R, P and Q or P and R. So these are the distribution laws which we apply to this one, so that in given well-formed formula is converted into appropriate conjunctive normal form. So now let us try to convert this particular kind of formula into the conjunctive normal form. So P implies Q implies P is what is given. So now first thing we need to do is to eliminate that implication. How do we eliminate this implication? By using a simple definition of material implication, that is P implies Q is nothing but not P or Q. So that is the reason why the first conditional P implies Q implies P will become not P or again Q implies P is written as not Q or P. That is the definition that we have used in the first step. So now this further simplifies to, you can use associative law, and then you can regroup or reorder it in such a way that it will become PR not PR not Q. So this is kind of case which we have talked about earlier, that is the degenerated case of the special case of conjunctive normal form. That is a degenerate case where you have all the rules, three rules are applied on this particular kind of thing. So now this PR not PR not Q is finally considered to be in that particular kind of conjunctive normal form. So this as such, you know, it appears to be not to be in the conjunctive normal form, but you can write it in this way, that PR not PR not Q, and the same thing which you can write it PR not PR not Q. So now this is nothing but this is like C1 and C2, where each C1 is nothing but a disjunct. So in this case PR not P or not Q, because PR not P is already true and all, because we know that it is a tautology. So anything whether Q is false or Q is true, that is going to be true only. So it is in that sense it is considered to be a valid formula also. Of course this is indeed a valid kind of formula in the propositional logic, because it is an instance of paradox of material implication. In the last class we showed that using natural deduction, we showed that P implies Q implies P is a theorem, or it is considered to be a valid formula. So what essentially we did here is that given a formula, we reduced this, we eliminated this implication by using De Morgan's laws and the definition of material implication, etc., and all, and we reduce the formula into a formula which consists of only disjunction or negation. So these are the only things which you will come across in the final formula. So some more examples which we take into consideration how to reduce a given formula into conjunctive normal form. So conjunctive normal form is conjunctions of disjunction. Each conjunct is combination of different formulas which are in the form of disjunction. So what is given to us is P, and P implies Q, that implies Q is what is given to us. So now what essentially one needs to do is, in this formula we have implication and conjunction is there. So now we need to eliminate this implication. How do you eliminate this implication? You use the definition. So that is A implies B is nothing but not A or B. So this is P, and P implies Q, that is taken as X, I mean that means not of X or Y is same as Q here. So that is what is the case in the what has happened in the second case. So now once you use the definition, so now if there is any negation outside the bracket and all, you need to push it inside by using De Morgan's laws. So now in the second step, the negation is outside the bracket and all, now you push it inside, negation of conjunction will become disjunction, negation of a formula P will become not P, not P or not P or Q, that is the first one, or Q is the case. This is not still in conjunctive normal form, that means not conjunctions of disjunction, but you have to reduce it further using further applying De Morgan's rules, and whenever you have not P etc. and all, use the notion of double negation. So the first formula not P or not P or Q will become now P and not Q, and Q remains the same thing. So now it is not P, now you use distributive law, X R Y and Z will become X R Y and X R Z. So that is what we have done here, not P or P and not P or not Q or Q and all, Q is remains the same and all. So now once you have done this thing, what you need to do is you have to reorder the formulas in such a way that there is some order which is maintained, the convention we need to follow, P preceded by Q etc. So now this Q, not P R P and not P R not Q, and the Q, if you use distributive law, it becomes Q R not P R P and then Q R not P R not Q. So now you drop the brackets and all. So now this again you can use some kind of reordering, it will become you can use associative law here, it will become P R not P and Q. So you have to ensure that unnegated term comes first, followed by that negation of its term, and then followed by that anything goes and all. So in the same way in this case also, not P R Q R not Q, that means first unnegated term came first and then the negated term comes later. So this is what we have reduced, a given formula P and P plus Q and plus Q is reduced to this one. So what's so great about reducing this particular kind of formulas and all. So now observe this particular kind of formula, this is like a X and Y kind of thing. So X and Y, when it is going to be true, when both conjuncts are true. So now in this case, if you observe the first conjunct, that is that involves P or not P or Q, P or not P is obviously a tautology. So anything whether Q is false or Q is true, that is going to be true only. That means the first conjunct is automatically, first disjunct is automatically true. So now coming back to the second one, here also we have a literal Q and its negation is there, so that means it is always true. Now irrespective of whether not P which occurs there in this formula, second formula, whether it is true or false, that is going to be true only. So that means the entire conjunct D1 and D2 both are true. So that is why the given formula is true, that means a given formula is a tautology. So how this happened and all, especially because each disjunct has a literal and its negation occurs in this particular kind of disjunct in a conjunctive normal form. So that makes this particular kind of formula true, that means a tautology, and hence the given formula is a valid kind of formula. So now a well formed formula is in CNF, especially when it has this form, it is a conjunctions of disjunctions. First you need to write talk about the connective that occurs there, so that is a conjunction of what, conjunction of disjunctions, and that is why D1 and D2 to Dn, where n is greater than 1, whereas A is considered to be a well formed formula which is in disjunctive normal form, the other way around, the dual of this one. If it is a disjunctions of conjunctions, so how you need to read this particular kind of formula, sometimes it will be confusing for us. In the case of conjunctive normal forms, so what appears here is it is a conjunctions of disjunctions in all D3 etc. So now DNF is disjunctions of conjunctions C3. So a conjunctive normal form is going to be true when all the disjuncts in that occurs in that conjunctive normal form is going to be true. So when this happens, especially when you have a formula like a literal and its negation occurs in this particular kind of formula, then each disjunct will become true, then that makes the conjunctive normal form true and hence valid. In the same way DNF, in the case of DNF, each conjunct has to be, suppose if each conjunct is false, then that makes the whole formula unsatisfiable enough. So for showing the validity you will use CNF, for showing the unsatisfiability you will be using the DNF. So DNF disjunctive normal forms are nothing but disjunctions of conjunctions. First you need to read the sign here, this is a disjunction of what, the conjunctions. In the same way in the conjunctive normal form, first you write the conjunction here, conjunctions of what, disjunctions D1 D2 D3 etc. So now there are some remarks which needs to be discussed here. So a well formed formula is in disjunctive normal form if it is an unnegated conjunction of variables, that means there is no formula which occurs like this that it is not of P or Q etc. and all, whereas individual letters will have negation and it can have P or it can have not P also, so either negated or unnegated. The procedure for finding DNF is exactly same as that of CNF, that means you remove the implication sign first by using the definition and then you push the negation inside and use De Morgan's laws and distributive laws etc. Then ultimately you will have in the case of DNFs you will have disjunctions of conjunctions and all, and if every conjunction in DNF contains some variables and negated and unnegated, then the given well formed formula is said to be inconsistent. So that means in any formula like this thing, they are all conjuncts and all, so like x1 x2 x3 etc, so they are all conjuncts. So now it so happened that you have x1 and not x2 in any one of this in all these conjuncts and all, so that means this makes this formula this makes this C2 false. In the same way C1 is also having that particular kind of thing, a conjunction and a literal and its negation occurs in each conjunct and all, that makes every conjunct false, and since all the P or Q is going to be false when both are false, that means every conjunct is false, then this is going to be inconsistent and all, or unsatisfiable kind of formula and all. So now the question comes to us is there may be some kind of perfect normal forms, a CNF, a conjunctive normal form is said to be a perfect normal form, especially if every conjunct contains as a disjunct every prepositional variable negated and unnegated that occurs in the whole well formed formula. For example, if you take example will serve our purpose here, so P R R and P R not Q. So this is this is an imperfect kind of a normal form. So what one needs to do here is this, that we need to find a perfect normal form corresponding to this imperfect normal form. So how do we find it? There is a procedure for finding it. So if in any conjunctive normal form D is a conjunct, that means D is a conjunct which does not contain some prepositional variables pk, then D is represented as dr pk and dr pk. If in any disjunctive normal form C is a disjunct which does not contain some prepositional variable pk. So how do we reduce an imperfect normal form into a perfect normal form? So the first one is this thing PR R and PR not Q, for example. Let's take into consideration this thing. So now this formula PR Q and not Q is written in this sense, PR Q or PR not Q. So now this is P is same as dropping the inconsistent disjuncts and all. What is the inconsistent disjunct? Q and not Q. If you drop that particular kind of thing, Q and not Q is obviously false and all, and PR false leads to P only. So now P leads to P is nothing but PRQ and PR not Q, dropping the inconsistent disjuncts and all. So now PRQ and PR not Q, that is the first one, and then the second one PRQ and PR not Q are all. So this is another kind of thing. Imperfect form that is translated into this one PRQ or R using the distributive law, and you can write it in this way PR not Q or R. So now again this reduces to P PRQ or PR not Q or R. So now P is equivalent to PR R and R. So it is R and R is reduced to F, so PRF is P only. Now PR R and PR not R. So now PR not Q or R and PR not Q or not R. So now we have, after doing all these things, we have something called a perfect normal form. So what is that we have done here is this, that we have reduced the given formula into corresponding kind of perfect forms. Imperfect forms have been translated into perfect kind of forms. So something is in imperfect conditional imperfect well formed formula can be reduced to a perfect kind of formula PR R and PR not. So now so this can be written as this one. So the first thing P it can be written as this one using disjunctive normal form. This is nothing but PRQ and so now this we are trying to translate it into perfect kind of form and all. So now PR, you are adding this particular kind of thing Q and not Q. This is nothing but PRQ and PR not Q. So this is using distributive property PR not Q and PR not Q and all. This is first is PRQ and this PR not Q. So now this reduces to just P1. So now what we mean by P is this one PRQ and PR not Q. So what exactly we are doing here is that since it is not in perfect normal form and all, conjunctive normal form where this is D1 and D2, so we are trying to reduce it into a perfect kind of normal form. So now using this particular kind of equivalence, we substitute it in this particular kind of thing. So now this P you substitute it here. So now what will happen, PRQ and PR0Q RR. So this is the first disjunctive knot. So now this will become this one. This is PRQ RR and this is and PR0Q RR. So this is the second disjunctive knot. So how did we get this particular kind of thing? First we included this particular kind of thing, PRQ and not Q. This is same as P only, we are not just doing anything new. So this is nothing but PRQ and PR not Q. So now the same thing, whatever we generated here, this we substituted in this one. So this is what we have written here, our disjunction R. So now this is what we get. So now the same thing, you substitute it into the second one, you will get so you will generate the other one PR. So now what you will do here is so now PRQRR and PR not QR. In the same way you can write P, so now P as PRR and not R. So this is same as P only, so now this can be written as PRR PR not R. So now you substitute this P value, whatever we got it here, into the second one. So now this becomes for P you substitute this one PRR and PR not R. This is the first thing, the whole thing which we got it for P. P is nothing but this one, the whole thing. R not R. So now this this is as it is and all, and so now this will become P R R R not R and P R R and P R R P R not a R. So PRR R not R, this is the first thing, and then you have to use this PR not R R not R. So now this seems to be in the perfect kind of normal form. So initially we have just PRR and PR not Q. So now if you are trying to write it in the normal form and all, we need to ensure that all the disjuncts that occur here will have all these letters and all. So whereas in this case Q is missing here, whereas in this case R is missing. So this is not in a this is not in a perfect form and all. A perfect form includes all the disjuncts and all, whatever disjunct occurs in the given formula. So for that reason what we have done is simply this, that we have just taken one formula into consideration which is an equivalent of this particular kind of thing P. For example, if you have X R P and not P is same as X only, because P and not P is obviously false and all, X R something which is false is X only, it is like X plus 0 is X. So now essentially what we have done here is that this is an imperfect normal form in the sense that the disjunct D1 doesn't consist of Q, the variable Q here. In the same way in the case of disjunct 2 we don't have R here. So we need to transform this thing in such a way that if you want to have it in a perfect normal form, then we need to make use of these particular kinds of transformations, and ultimately you will see here this is the final translated version of the same formula PRR and PR0Q, that is like this PRQRR and PR0QRR, and followed by that we have PRR0R and PR0R and not R and all. But now here, so can we say that this particular kind of formula is valid or not? So for validity, what needs to be the case is that all conjuncts have to be true. So that means each disjunct have to be true to make this formula true. So we can talk about such kind of thing for only these two formulas, PR not Q or R. At least literal and its negation is there, not its negation, some negated formula, unnegated formula is there. But when it comes to this particular thing, PR not PR Q or R, if this any disjunct will become false, it's going to make the whole conjunct false. Had it been the case that if it has at least one not R here, and then if you have some P and not P or something like that is here, then it makes all the conjuncts, all the disjuncts true, and it makes the conjunctive normal formula true. So this is the way in which one can convert an imperfect normal form, that is PRR and PR not Q, into this particular kind of format and all, where we have not changed the entire structure of the formula and all, but we made use of some definitions and all, like P is nothing but PR Q and not Q. And in addition to this particular kind of thing, definition and pushing the implication inside etc and all, so what we are trying to do is we are making use of some laws of logic also. So one is, the first one is law of identity, P and something which is a tautology is obviously P only, or identity law, it's not identity law, but PR, a contradiction, is obviously P only. It's like in the Boolean logic, PR 0, P plus 0 is P only. And the domination law, if you add anything, any contradiction to a given formula, contradiction dominates and all. So that is, the given statement is going to be contradiction. And in the domination law with respect to disjunction, if you add any tautology to a disjunction, disjunct, that is going to be true only. The tautology dominates over here. In the first case, contradiction dominates there. And idempotent laws, P and P is nothing but P, PRP is also P only. And commutative laws, as we know, P and Q is nothing but Q and P, which happens, which occurs for even disjunction also, PRQ is nothing but QRP only. Associative law, P and Q and R, or PRQ or R, the same as PR, now brackets Q or R etc. So these are things which we already know. And the De Morgan's laws are as usual, not of P and Q will become not P and not Q. And absorption law is simply seems to be a little bit surprising for us, something which is P or P and Q will become P. So now some more examples, how to convert not of P implies Q or R implies P into its corresponding conjunctive, disjunctive, normal forms. The first step, what you will do is you write, you remove the implication, so then P implies Q will become not P or Q. So that is followed by a negation of that particular kind of formula, or R implies P is written as not R or P. So now in the first disjunct, first disjunct, you have to push this negation inside, then it will become P and not Q, and R not R or P remains the same. So just let me work it on the board and all, so that you will get to know this thing in a better way. Just one formula which I work on it, and the rest of the formulas one can transform it into the appropriate DNFs and all. So the formula that we are trying to reduce is this thing, not of P implies Q implies not R or P. So now we are trying to reduce it into CNF. The CNF is like this, conjunctions of disjunctions D3 etc. So now the first thing which you do is you have to eliminate this implication and all. So now how do we eliminate this thing? So we have a definition, P implies Q by definition is nothing but not P or Q. So this is what you write it here, and then you remove it in the next step and all. So now this is not R or P. So now in the second step you remove this particular kind of implication. So now this will become, the whole thing is treated as X and this as Y. X implies Y is nothing but not X or Y. So now you substitute for X. This is not of not of not P or Q or not R or P. So now this is not not of this one will become this one, not P or Q or not R or P. So now you can use distributive law and all, then you will get not P or, so not P or Q or not R or not P or Q or P. Not of P implies Q, and then R P. Not of not not of not P implies Q. Yes, here thing is that not of not P or Q, it will become N. Negation of disjunction will become conjunction. Now this is as it is. So now this needs to be changed like this, not P and Q or not R or P. So now this step will become this thing. So now you apply this thing, not P and Q, not P and Q and not R, R not P and Q and not P and Q and P. So what is that happening? So now it is not P and Q or, so now this will become not P or, so now this thing we take into consideration and you remain, you keep it like this only, not R or P, and Q and is the one which is coming here. So now Q or not R or P. So now this is in the disjunctive form D1 and this is D2. Now it is a conjunction of D1 and D2, that is why it is called as conjunctions of disjunction, that is why CNF, conjunctive normal form. So now whether or not this formula is satisfiable or not, this is not in a perfect form and all. Now you need to reorder it and then you can write it like this. So not P or P, now this comes first, unnegated term comes first, followed by that you have a negated term, and then not R, and in the same way Q or not R, you write it in this way, P or Q or not R. So now in this case you have P or not P, which is already true, is a tautology. So now irrespective of whether not R is true or false, this is going to be T. So now even in this case also P or Q or not R, a negated term and an unnegated term is there here, so that means it ensures us that whether or not P is false or P is true, this whole formula is going to be T only. So that means the whole formula is going to be true, that means this formula is going to be valid formula. So in that sense we can talk about validity of a given formula, especially in the form of, in the case of CNF. So in this class what we have seen is that a given well-formed formula, we reduce it into its corresponding conjunctive or disjunctive normal form. Conjunctive normal form is nothing but is a conjunction of disjunctions, and disjunctive normal form is disjunctions of conjunctions and all. So the basic idea of reducing this conjunctive given formula into conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms is this, that the moment you see the structure of these formulas, you can immediately come to know that using the semantics of disjunction or semantics of conjunction, you will come to know especially in the case of CNF, if each D1 is true, then the conjunctive normal form is going to be true. In the case of DNFs, it's disjunctions of conjunctions. If each conjunction is false, then you can show that a given formula is unsatisfiable and all. So this is the advantage of reducing the given formulas into given well-formed formulas into its corresponding disjunctive or conjunctive normal forms. And sometimes it might appear that these formulas will not appear in a perfect form, like all the variables will not occur in a given formula. So we need to do a little bit of transformation without disturbing the truth value of it. Just like, you know, for example, you can replace P with P, R, Q and Q, Q and not Q. So that is P, R, Q and P and not Q and all. So like this, you know, one can transform imperfect normal forms into perfect normal forms. One example we have seen in this particular kind of class. In the next class, what you are going to see is that we will be making use of this conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms, especially in solving some kind of puzzles, as well as we will be making use of this conjunctive normal forms and disjunctive normal forms in analyzing some simple switching digital circuits. So we will talk about analysis of, as an application of this conjunctive and disjunctive normal forms, we will be talking about the analysis of simple digital switching circuits.